beautiful shades of different colors, reflecting the beautiful nature, having a deep intensity in her eyes and hoping for the better future. She is not an ordinary woman. She is the one with great desires, dreams and goals. Meet Karuna Tukaram. An artist believes painting is a soulful art. She works hard to develop paintings into beauty that speaks. Karuna is pursuing M.Tech in data science at SJC, Mysore. She is born and brought up in the heritage city, Mysore itself.
Childhood has been quite normal, like very normal childhood, but I've had this inclination towards art since I don't know when, maybe like 4 year old or 5 year old. So it's always been art over anything else, art over studies, art over anything. I hardly used to even go out and play with friends because running back from school and grabbing my sketch pad and painting, that's the only thing which gave me happiness. Memorable moments, there has been a lot of little memorable moments where I always used to go attend competitions in schools and every little competition which gave me, which is a major part of whatever I am today, because the exposure, the people whom I met through this journey, there has been a lot of inspiring people whom I've met, and it's been a major part of my journey and major part of whatever I am today. The memorable moment would be like when a very major artist comes up to you and says, I'm a little kid, like a 7th standard kid, he comes to me and says, the lines you're doing, you'll go somewhere, they're amazing. Those appreciations, they meant a lot to me then, yeah.
Attitude or habit, till now I've believed nothing can ever discourage me, that I'm there's been a lot of ups and downs, but I've never been demotivated by it. I've always kept myself motivated and I've always surrounded myself with, you know, very good people. So, and also once I start something, I make sure I finish it, because doing the wall painting for 17 hours, 18 hours, it's not an easy job, and you know, I inspire myself not to quit. Maybe that has kept me going very till late. Greatest influencer, I don't know, there have been a lot of artists, a lot of little artists who have inspired me a lot. These little artists who, you know, who actually paint for themselves. I see their Instagram handles and their social media handles and actually get inspired a lot by them. So there's been a lot of people like that who have inspired me through this journey. One thing an artist requires, I think, is a lot of positivity and a very good listener. Positivity, every person needs it, so an artist also needs it, and a listener is, you will have so many ideas which is running in your mind, and you know there has to be one go-to person whom you go to and say, no, this is what I want to do, you know, there has to be one good listener like that. Now, who has helped me in doing it? Though my friend circle is very little, I've met some amazing friends through this journey who have never discouraged me in doing anything. So yeah, a lot of friends. My teachers have taught me. You know, I've been taught by like 3 or 4 art teachers who have been you know, past Kava students and so many like that. So they have been major influencers in this, and also my friends who have been great listeners. Once you start doing something, opportunity starts coming your way. Which when I first started my wall painting, which was 5 years ago maybe, some journalists came up to me and asked me for the first interview. That was the first ever interview of my life. I didn't even know what to answer for most of the questions. And after that, you know, it actually inspired me to do better. Where, you know, a lot of opportunities started coming my way, and I started getting offers to do their wall paintings, to paint music studios and all that, and people actually started trusting me with their living rooms, with everything. So that's how a lot of opportunities have come my way after that. Family has been like a major strength for me. They have been very supportive. It was one of those lazy 7 holidays where where I had absolutely nothing to do. It was a very long break, and I hadn't even planned that I want to. It was a very random idea when I went to my mom and said, can I just paint the living room? And without even asking me a single question, she was like, go ahead. So they've been very supportive of whatever I do. I go to small little places in Mysore, the major places like Palace, like the market area and all that, and I sit there and paint, and my mom sits there holding all my painting bags. She doesn't even care if it's sunny, if it's rainy, anything. She just comes sit with me. They've been a very major support for me. Currently, I'm pursuing my master's in data science and SJC. Future plans is maybe to get a very nice job and save up enough so that this passion of mine becomes my profession. So that's it about that. I dream of owning my very own art studio. That's what I see. I have attended like a lot of competition. More than I spent my time in my school, I spent my time attending a lot of competitions. The most memorable among them, I would say, the national level Hindu competition, where I was in my 9th standard, where they give a topic and kids actually go prepare for it and then attend a competition. It was not like that. There were no topics. You just have to go to the place. They would come up with some random topic and the kids have to paint. There is actually some room for some thinking. That was a very different thing which I attended compared to others. So the topic which I randomly got was to paint, was to do something on Deepavali, where I had no idea. It was just how I enjoy the festival. I just put it on my paper. I actually had a lot of hopes that that was the best work of mine till date. Even today, if I try, I'll not be able to recreate that work. So I was actually it was time to announce the results, where I was actually eagerly waiting, because that was something which I was expecting, which I was confident about. So they announced the third prize. No, my name was not there. They announced the second prize. Not again. I was actually very discouraged. First prize, no, I'm not. I'm not even second. How do I even get the first? I was so demotivated. Then they announced the first prize and it was me. So even if some little thing demotivates me today, that is one incident I think about and wish myself to do better. So.
For her, the idea of painting on walls itself was fascinating. She started this 3 years back in her semester holidays, where she thought she should start painting on walls, and at that point of time, she had no
idea. One of my best work till date is, it's my fifth or maybe fourth wall painting, where the only color I've used is black. And it actually depicted my whole situation in 3 words. The whole abstract art came and ended up with 3 words, which has been my favorite till date. It's abstract. It has so many events going on. It has so many moods going on in there. That's been my favorite.
And at that point of time, she had no idea what kind of paints to use on walls or how proper the dimensions should be. She had no idea about anything. She expresses. It was an amazing self-learning process, and it took a lot for her to achieve perfection. She has dedicated her life in the field of painting since a very long time, and that has given her the idea of owning a small studio and giving her best of all in this field.